intentions of our hearts and minds and the words of our mouths be a blessing to you. Shut all the doors that should not be opened, and stop all words that should not be spoken, that we may reflect your love and compassion to all you put before us. We pray this in the blessed name of Jesus, your Son and our Lord. Amen.
What do we know about Peter? Does anybody, what do we know? I've got three questions. What do we know about Peter, Simon Peter? What was Simon Peter possibly thinking or feeling in the different situations? And how does we often feel thinking or when we are in those situations ourselves? Now, obviously, none of us probably have denied the Lord. Hope not. But anyway, as we know, at the end, it's okay. God forgave you. But what do we know about Peter? Anybody? Come on, this is going to be... It was a fisherman, absolutely. And at the beginning, he was called by Jesus first. And it tells you that at Matthew and Mark. But in Luke, it says he goes fishing with Peter and the other fishermen that Peter uses with him. And they couldn't catch any fish. So he said, throw your net over the other side. And they caught lots of fish. And when Simon and Peter realized that, he said, Lord, you know, we are not worthy. He fell on his knees. We are not worthy to be in your presence. So he called him in that way. He called all of them at that time. But in John, the first chapter, he changed his Simon to Simon, son of John. Or Simon Bar Yohanan. And he changed his name. He said, from now on you will be Cephas, which means Peter. Peter the Rock. Now, what do you think Peter thought? I mean, he was the first one called. And then his name was changed and he was called the Rock. How would you feel?
How do you think Peter felt then?
very spiritual, I would think, very special, maybe humble, but certainly, you know, things. Remember, Peter is very zealous. I mean, he reminds me of a teenager who is very gung-ho for the game and roots and cheers, and, you know, he's in there and he's, come on, guys, let's do it. And this is the type of man that Peter was at this time. But now we know also in Matthew 26, 31 through 35, if someone read that, that's page 905. You just have to turn a couple pages. Okay, there you go.
Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, sheep of the flock will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all the
They all made a declaration that they would stand by him no matter what. It's in Matthew, it's also again in Mark, the declaration and prophecy by Jesus that they would all fall away and that Peter would deny him. And again in Luke and in John 13, again, is the declaration and the prophecy. They were in Gethsemane right before the soldiers came to get him. We know that in the garden, they came to Jesus and the soldier had his ear cut off, which Jesus healed. In Matthew, Mark, and Luke, it just tells us that one of the disciples did it. But in John, it says that the disciple is Peter, defending as he had declared, for trying to protect his Lord. How does Peter feel then? When the Lord stops him and he heals the man. How would you feel if he just suddenly did something like that?
Embarrassed?
Yeah. Oh, I hurt someone. Oh my gosh. And Jesus is telling me not to do that. You know. Thank God he healed him. Put the ear back on, right? Would you probably feel the same as him at that kind of situation? I think we all would. We also know that Peter betrayed Jesus because it was prophesied by Jesus. He does it in Matthew 26, Mark 14, this is in your bulletin, Luke 22, John 18. And in all but John, we are told that Peter went out and wept bitterly. Do you recall a time in your life when you might have wept bitterly? And you realize, oh my gosh, I've hurt someone so bad. I have. I couldn't stop crying. I was out in the yard, and Dennis being German, he has two emotions, calm and anger. Most men, I mean, they can snap the anger really quickly. But he came out and he was yelling at me, and usually I just take it, and this was in Texas. But I didn't take it. I yelled back, and he said something about, "Be quiet, the neighbors will hear you." And I said, "What does it matter? You do the same thing. What, you can't take what you give out, you know?" And I ran in the house, and then suddenly I thought, oh my gosh, I have not only sinned against my husband, I have sinned against God. And my marriage is finished. And I sobbed and sobbed and I sobbed. And it was a bitter cry. It really was. I'm sure some of you might have had similar situations. But Peter was really, really, really destroyed that he did what he said he wouldn't do. Through these denial verses, what do you think that Peter was possibly thinking and feeling? Well, we know he went out and he cried bitterly. He was remorseful, yes? he was sad, he was, I would say, destroyed. What do you think? Destroyed by what he had done to his one Lord that he loved more than anything. I'm sure we have all hurt someone unintentionally, but we have hoof and mouth disease. My husband says I have it a lot. Anybody else have hoof and mouth disease? You don't think before you say it. You tell these more. Yeah. And then you're sorry you said it because they did not take it and believe in it. You too, Joseph. Yeah. Sometimes we just, we're not really thinking of what they might think. And Jesus taught in Matthew 5:23, I'm going to read that one. So if you are offering your gift at the altar, and there, remember that your brother has something that is against you, leave your gift there before the altar and go. First be reconciled to your brother, and then come and offer your gift. We're to reconcile. When we realize we've done something wrong, we're trying to go and reconcile with the person or with God. What we don't know about Peter is, did he ever go to Jesus and ask forgiveness? I don't think so. I haven't seen it anywhere in the gospel. It doesn't tell us. But when Jesus had risen again, he met the women in the garden, and he said to them, go and tell the disciples and Peter. Why did he add Peter? Because Peter probably would not have come because of what he had done. So he wanted Peter to come too, and he made sure, tell Peter that Jesus is going on to Galilee and that he will see them there. The first and second times they saw Jesus, they worshiped him, but it says in the scriptures, some doubted. Not just Thomas, some doubted. And it says it several times. The third time is today's gospel, on the beach. The ever-zealous Peter, when someone exclaimed, John, exclaimed, it's the Lord, swam to shore excited, and yet, do you think he wondered where he was with the Lord? He loved him. He was glad that he was okay. He was resurrected, but he wasn't totally gone anymore. I think Peter did wonder where he stood. I really do. Because you can get surmise it from the questions that Jesus asked. And the questions Jesus asked three times, a lot of people say that's because he denied him three times. But I think that when we are so shattered and so broken, and we don't know where we stand with the person that we love, especially the Lord, that we need that reassurance somehow. And Jesus' three questions give Peter that assurance. Okay, if you love me, do this. Feed my sheep. Tend my flock. You know, feed my sheep again, or feed my lambs. And then finally, at the end of that scripture, he says, follow me. He tells Peter how he's going to die. Because now Peter knows in these scriptures, he will not fail the Lord again. That's all we're done with. And Jesus has told him, this is what you're going to do. Because I know you love me. And you've been called to build my church. You've been called to do these things for me. And yes, you will die for me in the end. No matter what we're going through or have been through, Jesus is also telling us
tell your heart, he's speaking to us, tell your heart to beat again. If you know this song, you may sing along with it.